हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन कोर्स ऑफ मैकेनिकल मेजरमेंट एंड मेट्रोलॉजी। माई सेल्फ अभिषेक त्रिवेदी फ्रॉम मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एट एलजे इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। वी आर डिस्कसिंग फोर्स, टॉर्क, प्रेशर, स्ट्रेन एंड टेम्परेचर मेजरिंग इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स एज वेल एज द मेथड्स विच आर डायरेक्टली रिलेटेड टू द मेजरमेंट ऑफ सच पैरामीटर्स। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द टॉपिक नेम्ड एज स्ट्रेन मेजरमेंट, इन विच वी हैव डिस्कस व्हाट डू मीन बाय स्ट्रेन और वी कैन से द कंसेप्ट ऑफ द स्ट्रेन। Then we have discussed the basic classification of the strain measuring instruments. Those are mechanical instruments based on the mechanical instrument, based on the electrical instrument, based on the optical instruments. Then we have discussed the gauge factor, or we can say sensitivity factor, which is useful for the selection parameter, or we can say for the selection criteria of the given strain gauges. Then we have discussed a basic idea about the Rosset gauge and the delta gauge. Then we have discussed the theory of resistance strain gauge, how the strain gauge will be applicable, or we can say what is the basic working principle of the strain gauge. We have discussed these all topics in the previous lecture. Today we are going to start our next topic, that is the pressure measurement. To understand the pressure measurement, first of all let us understand what do you mean by pressure. First of all let us understand the concept of pressure, or we can say what do you mean by pressure. If on a single box, if I am going to apply a force on a single point, then this is known as a force. But if I'll apply the same force over the cross sectional area, so how much amount of the force that I have applied? I have applied the force over the unit area, or we can say the cross sectional area. Then this particular, suppose this is the cross sectional area, then I am applying the force over the area, then whatever the effect has been generated due to this force over the area, then those effect is known as a pressure. This is the basic concept of the pressure. Pressure can be written as pressure is equal to force which is applied divided by unit cross sectional area, or we can say area, cross sectional area over which the force is going to be applied. Do you remember, force is a point load, or we can say it is distributed over a single point. It is a spotted load, whereas pressure, that is the area load. It means you are not supposed to find the pressure over a single point. You are supposed to find the pressure over a surface. Suppose this is a tank which is filled with the water. If I were to calculate that what is the pressure which is going to be applied on the side wall, then I have to measure the total force which is generated due to the water resistance and the cross sectional area, or we can say the resisting area which is available to resist the force which is generated by the water. Then those particular dimensions is known as a pressure. So do remember, pressure is distributed over the area, whereas force is a pointed quantity, or we can say the parameter which is applicable over a single point. That is known as a pressure and the force. That is a basic difference between the force and the pressure. The unit of the pressure, that is unit of the force, that is Newton, as well as area, meter square. So we can say that unit of the pressure, that is the Newton per meter square, or we can write as a Newton per mm square. These are the basic unit for the pressure measurement, or we can say pressure. Other than this, we are supposed to use bar as the unit of the pressure. We are supposed to use Pascal as a unit of the pressure. We are supposed to use TOR, we are supposed to use TOR as a unit of the pressure. We are supposed to use ATM, we are using ATM as a unit of the pressure. So on, these all are the number of units which are applicable for the defining the quantity of the pressure. As per the basic requirement, as per the requirement, we have defined the pressure in different unit structures. In the mechanical industries, we are using the pressure in terms of bar. In the thermal industry, in the chemical industries, in the food processing industries, we are using the pressure in terms of bar. Whereas if you are discussing with the meteorological department, which is going to forecast the weather, which is going to forecast the seasonable outcome, or we can say seasonable monsoon season, seasonable different parameters which are totally based on the seasons, then those meteorological departments are using the ATM as a basic unit for the measurement of the pressure. Then Pascal, when we are discussing with the fluid mechanics, when we are discussing with the advanced fluid mechanics, then we are using the Pascal as a basic unit for the measurement of the pressure. When we are dealing with the vacuum pressure, when we are dealing with the very low pressure, which is below the atmospheric pressure, then we are discussing with the TOR. TOR is a very much useful pressure measuring element, or we can say pressure measuring quantity, or we can say pressure measuring unit for the measurement of the vacuum pressure, or we can say negative pressures. Then TOR is very much applicable. So all the units are having that different perception, all the unit having that different idea behind the application. As per the application, we are using the different units for the measurement of the pressure. At the end, pressure means the total force which is applied over the unit surface area. It is known as a pressure. Now, what do you mean by pressure? Then we can say that pressure is defined as the amount of the force which is applied to the surface or the distributed over the surface, and which is being measured as the force per unit area. As I have written, that the pressure is equal to force per unit area, then this is known as a pressure. Pressure is directly varied with the position, or we can say depth, within the static fluid. Suppose this is a tank which is filled with the water. This particular condition is known as a static fluid condition. It means if the body which contains the fluid, if it is moving, then we can say that the fluid is moving. If inside the body, if the fluid itself is moving, then we can say that it's a moving body, or we can say moving fluid. Whereas here the body is at the stable condition, as well as the water which is filled inside the body is also in the stable condition, then we can say that this is the static condition of the fluid. Suppose I am going to measure the pressure over here. I'll change the color of the pen. I'm going to measure the pressure over here at the first point. This is the measurement of the second point, measurement of third point, measurement of the fourth point. Then, as per the Pascal's law, as you are increasing the height of the liquid above the measuring point, then the pressure is directly increases. Pressure is directly proportional to height. If we are going to measure the pressure, we can say that if I have to replace the directionality, sign of directionality, then I will replace it as a rho g into h. We can say that p is equal to rho g h, where h, that is the height above which, which is available above the point of measurement, g, that is the gravitational acceleration which is applicable. Ideally, we are taking g as a 9.81 meter per second square, and rho, that is the density of the given liquid. Suppose we are using water, then we are taking as a density 1000 kilogram per meter cube, that is the density of the water. If we are dealing with the mercury, then we are taking the density as a 13600 kilogram per meter cube. So rho, that is the density which is directly depends over on the particular material which we are going to use for the measurement of the pressure. So what does it says? That suppose I am going to measure the pressure at this particular point, then the pressure is available as a p1. If I am going to measure the pressure over here, then it is p2. Over here at the third point, this is p3, and at the end this is p4. So as the height is increases, or we can say as the depth is increases, we can say that the pressure is directly increases. So I can say that p4 is greater than p3, is greater than p2, is greater than p1. This is the basic concept of the pressure. Based on this concept, we are designing the submarine, we are designing the naval bodies which is deep inside the sea water, or we can say which is deep inside the river, floating river water, as well as we are going to design the different aerospace aviation elements, or we can say aviation vehicles, or by which we are going to define the atmospheric pressure, or we can say the pressure effect which is exerted over those particular vehicles. So to designing such kind of vehicles, aviation vehicles, or we can say naval bodies, naval vehicles, we are going to use such concept. Pressure is unaffected by the shape, or we can say confining boundaries. Let us take the example. Suppose this is the reference line, a rectangular box has been placed filled with the water, a curved surface has been placed here the physical contact has been made, make sure that which is filled with the water. Over the same height, suppose I am going to measure the pressure, over here is known as the PA, here I am going to measure the pressure is known as the PB. Then as per the principle, pressure PA is exactly equal to pressure PB, irrespective of the shape, irrespective of the confining boundaries, irrespective of the wall condition. The pressure which is available at a particular height h is the same for all. So we can say that the pressure is unaffected by the shape, or we can say confining boundaries, or we can say the boundary conditions. Guys, this is the basic concept of the pressure. Now we are going to discuss the different types of pressure. To understand the different types of pressure, first of all let us understand the basic concept of the pressure. Suppose I am going to plot a graph. Here I can say that this is the zero condition, this is the condition for the pressure, definition of the pressure. Suppose this line, if I will take as a reference line, or we can say absolute zero line, then from the absolute zero line, as we all know that we are supposed to feel some sort of atmospheric pressure. The atmospheric pressure, that is 1.01325 bar. This amount of the pressure that we are going to feel in a normal day over our skin, the pressure is due to mass of the air. As we all know that each and every molecule of the air contains some sort of the mass, and due to the some sort of the mass, they are possessing some sort of the dead weight, and due to the dead weight we are supposed to find some sort of the load over the skin. And if the load is distributed over your body, then we can say that we are supposed to feel some sort of the pressure due to the dead weight of the mass. And this particular pressure is known as the atmospheric pressure. Suppose we have the atmospheric pressure value, then if I'll plot the horizontal line, then this particular line is known as the atmospheric pressure line. Atmospheric pressure line. If the pressure is above the atmospheric pressure, like we are going to find some sort of the pressure in the pipeline, we are going to find some sort of the pressure in the chemical industries, we are supposed to find some sort of the pressure of the water which is coming from your household tap elements, then those particular pressure, if I am going to measure those particular pressure from the atmospheric line, do remember, if I am going to measure the pressure from the atmospheric line which is above the atmospheric line, then the pressure is known as the gauge pressure. The pressure which is measured by the gauge, it is known as a gauge pressure. On the opposite side, suppose I am going to measure the pressure from the atmospheric pressure line, and if the pressure is below the atmospheric pressure, then particular pressure is known as a vacuum pressure. Suppose I have to conduct the vacuum, then what I am supposed to do, I will simply suck the air. If I will suck the air, then there is no any cause of the dead weight, there is no any reason behind the dead weight, then automatically the pressure will be fallen down, then the pressure is known as a vacuum pressure. Suppose if I will measure all the pressure from the absolute zero line, then the pressure is known as an absolute pressure. If I am going to measure this particular pressure, then it is known as an absolute pressure. This is also known as the absolute pressure. Whatever the pressure which is measured from the absolute zero line, then the pressure is known as the absolute pressure. Absolute pressure, the types of the pressure. You are not supposed to remember each and every definition of the pressure, but you are supposed to remember that what are the basic types of the pressure that we are using in the day-to-day life. Then atmospheric pressure, we have discussed the gauge pressure, vacuum pressure, and the last one, that is the total pressure which is available over the system. So this is the basic type, or we can say this is the basic characteristics of the pressure measuring instruments. Then the next one, that is a piezometer. Now we are going to discuss the different elements, or we can say the different measuring instruments which are useful for the measurement of the pressure. First of all, we are starting with the piezometers. as the figure shows, the piezometer is useful for the measurement of the pressure. Suppose this is the pipe from which some liquid, or we can say some fluid A, that is flowing. If I'll discuss fluid, then do remember one thing. What do I mean by fluid? Fluid means it contains liquid as well as it contains gases. All the liquids, all the gases, all the steam, vapors, whatever element, or we can say whatever the matter which can flow, those all fall under the category of the fluid. So do not get confused that if I am discussing like fluid, then you are not supposed to confuse that I am discussing about the liquid only. I am discussing about the liquid as well as gas, both. Whatever the element, whatever the matter which can flow, we are discussing as a fluid. So the pipe is filled with the fluid. If I'll make a junction with the pipe, and if I'll extend the surface like this, the surface is open to atmosphere. Here the atmospheric condition is there. The surface is open to atmosphere. So whatever the pressure is generated inside the pipe, the same pressure will be generated inside this particular pipe as well. And if the diameter of the pipe is small, then due to the capillary action, the liquid, or we can say the fluid, will start rising inside the capillary pipe, piezometer tube. Due to the capillary action, the liquid, or we can say the fluid, will start rising in the piezometer tube. Once it will start rising inside the piezometer tube, it will achieve some sort of the height. And whatever the height is achieved by the particular fluid, we are going to measure the height h, and we are using a simple equation, p is equal to rho g h, where rho, that is the density of the given fluid, g, that is the gravitational acceleration, take as an ideal 9.81 meter per second square, and h, that is the height, or we can see the difference of the height, or we can see the measurable height which is available from the reference line to the free end of the liquid line. This particular height is known as h. And we are going to measure the value of the h by the linear dimensions, and then we are calculating the pressure. This is known as a piezometer. The piezometer itself having some sort of the limitation. The piezometer is not useful for the measurement of the high pressures because it is open to atmosphere. So as the value of the pressure increases, do remember, as the value of the pressure increases, the value of the height is also increases drastically. And if the value of the height is increases drastically, then we are supposed to provide the higher and higher and higher piezometer tube, and which is not feasible for the measurement, for making it as a proper applicable to the mechanical industries. So piezometer is useful in the mechanical industries, but up to some limitations. Very basic limitation behind the piezometer is you are not supposed to measure the pressure from certain range. Piezometer is useful for the measurement of the low to medium pressure range only. Then we are going to discuss U-tube manometer. Manometer is the instrument which is useful for the measurement of the pressure. Those all instruments are known as a manometer. And the name U-tube itself suggests the shape of the manometer, that is U-shaped. So the figure shows the U-tube manometer. As I have told you that the first shape of the manometer is in the U shape, then it is known as a U-tube manometer. The particular U-tube manometer is useful for measurement, or we can say to find the difference of the pressure. In the piezometer, we are measuring the pressure PA, whereas in the U-tube manometer, we are going to find the difference between PA and PB. If the two junction pipes, or we can say if the two pipes are passing and the fluid will flowing inside the pipes, and if I were to measure the difference between the both the fluids, then I am supposed to use U-tube manometer. If I have to maintain the flow, if the basic requirement is we have to provide the flow which is starting from the A and ending in the B, or reverse case, if the flow is required from the B to A, then the pressure difference is required. Now from the direction of the motion of the fluid, we are supposed to make sure that which particular pipe required the higher pressure compared to other one. So for measurement of the difference of the pressure, we are supposed to use U-tube manometer. So this is the basic concept of the U-tube manometer. So this is the basic concept of the U-tube manometer. We can say where the U-tube manometer is applicable. Now we have already discussed that if we are going to draw a reference line, or we can say if we are going to draw a datum line, then above the datum line and below the datum line, the pressure is exactly same. So I can say that if I will draw the datum line, then I can eliminate the bottom side of the YouTube manometer. It means I am not supposed to take the bottom side of the datum line as a measure for the measurement of the pressure. So what I am supposed to do, I will simply measure the pressure which is above the datum line. I will simply measure the pressure which is above the datum line. So how I will measure the basic pressure? Suppose this is the pipe A, this is the pipe B. It contains the liquid A, we can say fluid A, fluid B. Here this is the height H1, the height H2, the light liquid. Suppose this both the liquid is same, then I can say that having the density rho 1, here the, having the density rho 1, the dark portion of the liquid is known as the heavier liquid. We can say that the density having the value of rho 2. Let's say we are using mercury, or we are using any sort of the liquid or any sort of viscous oil for the measurement of the pressure, for the transformation of the pressure as well. Now, as I have told you that above the datum line, the pressure is same. So I can say that this is the above side of the datum line. I can say that the particular pipe contains the pressure PA, pipe inside the pressure, plus the datum height which is generated having the liquid rho 1. So I can write it the pressure as per the law of the pressure rho gh. So I can write it as a rho 1 g, let's say h2. Suppose this is the height h2. As I have told you that above the datum line the pressure is same, so is equal to the pressure in the opposite side of the pipe, let's say pb, plus the first head of the pressure contains the liquid rho 1. So I can say that rho 1 g H1, plus on the bottom side we have the liquid rho 2, then I can say that rho 2 g of H2. So if I have to measure the pressure difference, what I am supposed to do, I will simply make PA minus PB. We can say that rho 1 g in bracket H1 minus H2 plus rho 2 g of H2. This is the basic equation for the measurement of the YouTube manometer pressure, or we can say for the measurement of the pressure by using the YouTube manometer. I hope you have properly cleared about the basic concept of the YouTube manometer and how the YouTube manometer is applicable or useful for the measurement of the pressure difference. Do remember one thing: piezometer is useful for the measurement of the single pipe pressure, whereas YouTube manometer is useful for measurement of the pressure difference only between the two different pipe. YouTube manometer is further distributed, or we can say further differentiated, in the different categories, like simple YouTube manometer, differential YouTube manometer, upright YouTube manometer, downright YouTube manometer. But those all classification is not in our syllabus. Those are fulfilled in the fluid mechanics. In particular our syllabus, you have to remember that YouTube manometer is a pressure measuring instrument which is useful for the measurement of the difference of the pressure between the two pipes. So guys, over here we are going to wind up our lecture. What we have discussed today, we have started a new topic known as a pressure measurement, then we have discussed the different types of pressure, and then we have discussed the two different basic instruments which are useful for measurement of the pressure. The first one, that is a piezometer, and the second one, that is the YouTube manometer. From next lecture we are going to discuss the Pirani gauge and MacLeod gauge. Till then, thank you.